Welcome students to my channel Bio World, and this two video is a continuation of the chapter transpiration. In this video we are going to discuss about the structure of the stomatal apparatus, that is guard cells along with the epidermal cells that I have drawn over here. You can see on the board there are two guard cells with the epidermal cells, one with open stomata and the other with closed stomata. You can see the labeling I have marked the subsidiary cells or the epidermal cells. They are the outside which surrounds the guard cells, and guard cells layered by two walls, the inner thick wall and the outer thin wall. And inside the guard cells you can see there are chloroplast and nucleus also. This chloroplast helps in synthesis of food by photosynthesis, by which the guard cells inner concentration rises, that helps in the endosmosis of water from the epidermal cells, making the stoma open in the day. And the same guard cells in the night, this because of the absence of the sunlight, the chloroplasts do not function and no synthesis of sugar or food takes place in the night, that loses its turgidity and the stoma closes during night. So this is the most important structure that helps in the process of transpiration, because this open stomata helps in releasing out the vapor from the leaves. So these two diagram as per the chapter is very important. One is open stomata guard cell and another is closed stomata guard cell. Along with the subsidiary cells or epidermal cell, these guard cells are known as, the full structure comes under stomatal apparatus. And the mechanism of stomatal opening and closing comes under different hypotheses. There are potassium ion hypothesis, there are sugar theory. So we need to study about them, that how this mechanism, how the sugar synthesizes, how the influx of the potassium ion inside takes place, and that raises the concentration of the guard cells opening the stoma. The next which I wrote here are the factors affecting transpiration. Now, transpiration being the physiological process guided by some of the factors. Some factors are external in nature. By external, what we understand, the factor affecting from outside. An internal, that is inside the plant, or internal factor, inner factor that helps in the process of transpiration, either in a negative way or the positive way. Now, external factors includes light, humidity, temperature, wind velocity, carbon dioxide. Now, you don't need only to learn the names or the headlines of the factor, but we have to understand how these factors affect transpiration directly or indirectly. Like if it is light, now what is light here? Light intensity, intensity of light, the concentration of the light is very important to understand, because transpiration do rises when there is high intensity of sunlight or any other light even. So light affects transpiration directly. If light intensity rises, the rate of transpiration rises in plant. Now humidity again has a different way to affect transpiration. Now humidity is the meaning of, the humidity means here that the amount of water vapor in the atmosphere. So definitely if the amount of humidity, water vapor in the atmosphere, or the humidity is higher in the atmosphere, definitely that means that concentration of water vapor is more outside. So the release of water vapor will decrease if humidity is more. So humidity here is affecting transpiration inversely. That is humidity rises, transpiration decreases. Third is temperature. Again, temperature, rise in temperature or high temperature, more temperature will increase the rate of evaporation, increasing transpiration. Wind velocity is again the directly proportional, that is more the wind velocity, more the wind is flowing with a speedy nature, raises the rate of transpiration. Carbon dioxide is inversely proportional to the transpiration, the rate of carbon dioxide more in the atmosphere will help in closing the stoma, and that will lead to decrease in the rate of transpiration. So these are some more, this is the soil water is also there under external. These are some of the factors that affect transpiration externally. But we have to understand how, whether it is in the increasing factor increases transpiration or decreases transpiration. That is very important. Now internal, we have the structure, the anatomical view of the leaves, the number of stomata, the structure like sunken stomata in nereum helps in decreasing the rate of transpiration. Now some of the plants, those are succulents, those which are found in desert area, those who are found in the scarcity of water, there the transpiration need to be controlled. And hence structure of the stomata or the anatomy of leaves is very important there to enhance transpiration or decreases transpiration. So under internal factor there are factors like how the stomata shape is, how the leaf anatomy is, that helps or increasing the rate of transpiration or decreasing. The structure pattern means only anatomical structure of the leaves. So these are the some external and internal factor. Under internal factor we have adaptation also. Like cactus is a succulent, the cactus is a desert plant. So we know that the cactus have spines over the surface of the body and they do not have large surface area of the leaves. Why? Because more the surface area, more would be the rate of transpiration. So to control transpiration, as it is found in scarcity of water, it has spine and that spine do not releases water vapor as much as the broad surface leaves. So these are some of the factors or adaptation that helps in controlling transpiration. So hopefully you have liked this topic under transpiration. So if you have liked this topic, please do like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching it.